slow it down. Slow down your stroke rate for me and try to keep that same pace. Slow down. You can do it. I know you can. Go, ready? One, two, drive. Whoop. One, two, drive. One. Okay, here's a common mistake right here. I think you think you're gonna make this go harder by whipping your head back to kind of initiate the movement. Remember, everything is relaxed when you're in the movement. You don't have to have that tension in your head and your neck and throw it back to move. And you're not gonna whip it back using your shoulders. These are your primary drivers right there, and you can do it. Those are great times if you can hold it. That was really good, and you looked really strong on there. But what I like to see you do is be able to achieve that score without a stroke rate that high. And I think it's possible. Your technique looks, you know, not that bad. Plus, you're long-legged from here to here. So go ahead and do it again. Relax the elbows at the end. Think to yourself, one, two, four, then drive. Looks good. I mean, a rowing stroke is like a golf stroke. We give you the basics and you spend a lifetime trying to perfect it. Little things would be, for every inch that the handle moves here, the seat should move the same. If your seat moves more than your handle, it's called shooting the tail. And basically, a lot of that energy is wasted in just shooting your tail back. I only saw like one or two strokes. That's actually not that bad either. The other thing is, I think you have a tendency, if I wasn't standing here, to want to dive back into the next one and kind of keep your head up. Number one, get more air. Number two, it'll keep everything else just moving in a direct plane. Boom, boom, boom,